All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503 here in beautiful Santa Monica. Got Santa Monica High School right behind us. Got some guys on the football field running some routes. It's beautiful today. First day of sunshine since we've been here. Saturday. Today is New Year's Eve. We got the pep rally tomorrow. Wisconsin's got their pep rally today down at the pier. We're about four blocks away, right down that road right there. So this is how we're doing it in the Rose Bowl 2012. So hopefully we'll get a victory to really celebrate this thing, and I'll give you guys some footage tomorrow of the pep rally. All right, guys, see you soon. Go Ducks. You're on, man.
Live at the Rose Bowl.
Hey, go Ducks, guys.
Amen.
Go Ducks.
Go Ducks. There you go.
Go Ducks.
Awesome.
Cool glass.
Give him a fist bump.
Cool glass.
Yeah, blow it up.
Coming to you from the Rose Bowl.
All right. Welcome back, everybody. Sports Chat 503 here at the tailgate. About an hour and a half. It's like 12:45-ish right now. Game starts at 2. Plenty of people here. We're on the golf course. Packed house today. Lots of Badger fans. Tons of Duck fans. This one I have a very good feeling about. You know, if we lose, we lose. But God, I got a good feeling about taking this victory today. If we win, it means we're probably going to go into next season top five, going into our whole national championship hunt, and we will be having a couple 3 cupcakes at the beginning of the season. If we lose, we're still probably going to end up being a top 10 finisher because of everybody else who's going to be losing in the next little week here. Stanford game is tonight. That's going to be a big one for the Pac-12 as well. But today is beautiful. About 80 degrees up here in Pasadena. We were at Santa Monica, and it was much cooler down there. But Duck fans are representing today. So go Ducks, everybody. Enjoy. I'll try to get as much footage as I can unless my camera gets taken by security. All right, guys. Adios.
You can choose, right? I could do one hand.
is. No, dude. If you got a property, do it. Right on. Go Ducks! Can I get your outfit on camera?
So probably, yeah, of course.
Top to bottom, homes.
So I ran into
what's his name? Michael
Cam.
Dyer.
No, Cam.
Newton.
Yeah, and he said, you know what? If he would have been now, I think we would have played a world in overtime.
No way.
He said, no way.
That's right. Well, now he's handing the ball off to Stewart, bud. Looking primo. Represent the South.
Thanks, sir.
Yeah!
Thank you. bomb to the end of the two.
The wind starting on the stop for the Ducks. Game one, second down and nine.
Yeah.
Gunter.
Oh!
unbelievable game. Have this thing. They are a great team that can't take anything away from us.
That's one!
Can't take anything away from us. That team was awesome. They had every chance to win it. We still won it. Came down to the end, and he spiked the ball with 0 seconds left. Sports Chat 503 here from the balcony overlooking Santa Monica High School right here. Got the hills in the background all the way. Give you a nice little beach shot there all the way to the ocean. Zoom in here for you. Look at that ocean right in there. Pretty sweet place. All right. So, huge game for the Ducks. Obviously, I can understand where people are kind of upset with the idea that I had the chance at the national championship game last year and had a pretty good look at it again this year. So, I can see where some people think that the Rose Bowl is, you know, maybe a step down from the national championship. But being an old school Duck, man, that was seriously one of the best nights I've had as a Duck fan in my entire life. It was awesome. We needed a Rose Bowl. Even if we had a national championship, we still need the Rose Bowl to fill out our trophy case, you know. Being down here in the land of the Trojans, you know, they would have killed us if we had won 3 Pac-10 championships in a row and not come back with one bowl victory. They would have eaten us alive for that. So, had to have one of them. And you can always think about the past, obviously. Last night I was having a lot of conversations with people about just that. Like how last year, you know, the Michael Dyer run where he was down, everybody thought he was down, the ref didn't blow the whistle and the kid kept running, and so obviously maybe he wasn't down. And then this year, to have the last play be Russell Wilson spiking the ball with 2 seconds to go, I knew the game was over as soon as he spiked the ball because the clock doesn't stop with the moving of the chains like the clock stops after a timeout. And when they put that ball down, the refs put the ball down, they moved back, they started winding the clock, and he spiked it. It was the most surreal moment to have that, because they were just marching right down the field. It looked like they were going to get into a touchdown. It looked like we were going to have an overtime game. So, and even then, if they do get that touchdown and go into overtime, that doesn't necessarily mean that Wisconsin's going to win at that point. I mean, we're still talking about a team that we couldn't stop and that they couldn't stop. So, who knows what happens there? But it was just fantastic games, great atmosphere, beautiful day, really, really beautiful. I'm amazed that I even have this much of a voice left. And just a great day for Duck fans. So I was up late last night till about 2 in the morning partying on this one. We went down to the 3rd Street Promenade last night. 3 hours after the game, went down about 11 or 10 at night. And hung out with Duck fans down there. They were partying. I mean, it was a great atmosphere. So thank you to the Duck fans. Thank you to my family. Thank you to everybody else out there for watching Addicted to Quack, Oregon Live, however you're getting this video or whatever. Sorry for having me on here as much as I was. I was just fired up for it. And, of course, special shouts out to my dad who can't be here. Got that foot injury. So a lot of this video was intended for his purposes more than it was intended for the Classic Sports Chat 503 audience. Other shouts out to Kurt from Addicted to Quack, or not Addicted to Quack, from Fish Duck, and he puts his stuff on Addicted to Quack on the vlog, but Kurt and I had a little conversation at the pep rally, and I was going to try to videotape that, and of course I forgot my video camera at that point. It was with my wife, so that's just classic for me. But shouts out to him as well, and the Fish Duck site, definitely go there and check that out. Check out the whole game recap, and then if you're into basketball, switch gears and start going into basketball, people. That's how we do it. Okay, guys, Sports Chat 503, watch the recap. Bo and I will be in the studio and breaking the whole thing down for everybody. So thanks a lot, guys. Happy New Year. Go Ducks.